professional skateboarder is accused of killing a man, and today he faced a judge.
Say the skateboarder is suspected in a deadly DUI crash on Vashon Island.
Corey Kennedy's blood alcohol level at the scene was at 0.10, just above the legal limit. He declined to appear for his bail hearing for fear, his lawyer said, that his reputation might be permanently tarnished.
It appears the driver was traveling too fast. Failed to negotiate the turn to the left.
45-year-old Preston Magater, a skateboarder known as Big Dog, died at the scene. The deputy prosecutor confirmed that Kennedy has a history of speeding while driving. Now the King County prosecutor has until early next week to decide whether to charge him with vehicular homicide or let him go.
So what's up, guys? Let's just go straight to it. On Wednesday night, it was announced that Preston Magater, a.k.a. P-Stone, a pretty well-known ex-professional skateboarder and videographer for Thrasher, died fatally in a car accident. On what appeared to be separate news, it was also known that Corey Kennedy, girl skateboards, Corey Kennedy, Nike SB skateboarder, Corey Kennedy, was involved in a fatal car accident to where there was involuntary manslaughter or homicide. Turns out these two events were actually one and the same. P-Stone was in the car with Kennedy. Kennedy was intoxicated at the time on Vashon Island and apparently hit a curve, wasn't able to manage quite, you know, the way it should, hit the guardrail, then hit a tree. According to locals that lived in the area and saw the damage of the vehicle, they said that pretty much the passenger side of the vehicle was gone. So skateboarding loses one of its finest in the business, you know, Preston. And it's just so crazy. It just shows how much love skateboarding had for P-Stone, because his GoFundMe account, I believe, don't quote me on this, but I believe was set to a goal of $100,000, and it exceeded that within like 3 days. You want to talk about tight-knit, you know, community? That's skateboarding for you. P-Stone made his name, friends, family, was loved, a beloved person in the community, and now he's gone. Now, there's so many angles to this, I've already seen people on comments on Instagram pointing fingers at Kennedy saying, dude, you're pretty much a murderer for what you did. Now, there's other people also saying, dude, P-Stone and Corey were like so close, they were homies, it's an accident. Accidents happen, which is completely true. That is absolutely true. So while there's a set of folks arguing amongst themselves, the truth, the undeniable takeaway is there was DUI. There was driving under the influence. Guys, you know, I don't mean to sound like a dad, and by any means am I ever telling any of you guys how to live your life, but there needs to be a rational part of your brain. No matter who you are, no matter what you like to do, if you're gonna be into drinking, getting high, whatever, don't mix driving into that. It turns out like this. So now look what happened. We got a dead person that was loved deeply and dearly by the community, that leaves behind a family and kids, and we have a super talented, loved skateboarder whose career practically ended. And for those, you know, I've never met Corey in person, but the dude looks like such a nice guy. Just likes to have fun, super nice, super chill, super humble. We all remember the video whenever Corey was first announced pro, that the girl team pretty much like set him up in a park, and all the little kids in the park were like skating his pro model. And he like was like just skating, doing his thing, kind of noticing, thought it was weird. Such a nice guy, so humble, and nothing positive could ever come out of drinking and driving. In this case, Corey didn't die, but someone else is dead. Someone else is dead because this took place. And it's one of those things to where you would think it's so engraved in everybody's brain, it's so marketed of how dangerous it is, but yet we still can't seem to get past this learning curve. I mean, we got people in skateboarding who lost their lives to diseases, to health conditions, like Marnell, you know, partial consequences of diabetes. We got freaking Dylan, who died of leukemia. I mean, these are things that are almost inevitable. And we have, on the other side of the spectrum, people that are voluntarily putting themselves behind the wheel while intoxicated. Definitely a dark day in skateboarding. And there needs to be a takeaway. Nothing could be sadder in this than not learning a lesson. So guys, like I said, just put two and two together. Don't mix those two. If you're gonna be getting drunk and getting high, don't get behind the wheel, please. You might not kill yourself, you might not lose your life, but others may while you do that. Our condolences to Pistone's family. Our condolences to Corey's family as well. Basically lost both of them. Just a few facts. He was to go to court yesterday, Tuesday, the 5th, to see what the outcome of that trial was going to be. If convicted, he could face 8 to 10 years in prison. And it's just, like I said, a dark day in skateboarding. Let's hope for the best. Let's put him in our prayers, and I'll keep you guys informed. Thanks for watching. Catch you guys on the next one.